Remember some adventures you went on when you were younger?
When I was younger?
Yes.
Taser. I don't really know, because you catch me off. Oh. But we had a lot of young friends. And
remember any of the places you went to? Or?
Not really.
How do I know who I am without my memories? I guess you just go by how you're feeling at that moment.
So you're finding it a little difficult to remember some of your travels from when you were younger?
No, I don't have difficulty with that. Sometimes I don't know what to say.
This is from your trip to Japan.
Hmm.
Do you remember going to Japan?
No.
No? I remember a conversation with my mom. It was over the phone. She was aware that she was forgetting things. We had gone through all of this with my grandfather, with her dad. Went searching for nursing homes with her, for him. We would visit him, all of that. So we kind of had visited this before. So I remember asking her what I should do when things get bad, when things get worse. And she didn't really have an answer.
Alzheimer's disease is a form of dementia. It actually causes trouble with memory and concentration, focus and decision making, and also communication and language.
Do you know that you're diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease?
That I am diagnosed?
Yes, with Alzheimer's.
No, I don't know anything about that.
The biggest challenge has been that while we have advanced public policy and research, we still struggle because we see people that are dealing with it every day, that get diagnosed, and then we have caregivers who struggle.
For about a year, we started looking at some places, and we tried to have my mom stay with us as much as possible, you know, either at my house or my sister's house, but it didn't have the structure that she needed, and we had kids going in and out. She would get very confused as to who was there, who wasn't, and she just wanted to go back to her house, and she did not want to stay with us. So then that's when we knew we needed to look at some other places. She needed something definitely different in her life. She wasn't happy how she was.
You come in one day and they're telling you you're going to do this and that, and that was great because that was fun and felt like you were doing something. With other people.
When we moved her in, the day that we went, we were all set for it to take a long time. But she was absolutely fine. She said goodbye and that was it, and we left. It wasn't what we were expecting. So the next day I came back with my two sons to show them where Grandma was. And when we went to her room, she had packed up everything. She told me she really, you know, tried. She stayed, in her mind she said that she stayed there for a year and a half, even though it was only one night. I guess I'd say the one thing that helped is that she was always very happy. She's was a social worker. And even as her memory would fade, there would still be glimpses for quite a while of my real mom jumping back in.
Well, the people are real friendly. And sometimes I'd look around for someone I could help or something like that. So that's good for my side of it.
We can't give them a cure. We can't give them an answer right away. So what our challenge is to help them along the journey of this and keep them supported.
I don't think they do put the money into it or the focus on it. It's just, it's not as important to people as it should be. I think when it affects people, they understand. But until it affects them, they really don't understand. They think it's just what happens to everybody when they get old.
You'd be hard-pressed to meet someone and they say that they have no idea what Alzheimer's is or haven't been impacted at all. You know, whether it's a grandmother or an uncle or a mother or father. You know, somebody knows somebody with the disease.
She's just very happy. She's not even sad about what she's missing out on. She doesn't realize it, and she's just happy.
It's like you get up in the morning and you don't complain and everything because this is the good stuff.